In this week's episode of The Walking Dead, we finally get to the farmhouse, which is where fans of the comic book have been excited for us to get to for a long time. Herschel can operate on Carl, who's dying, but Shane and Otis need to get to the local high school and get some supplies. This gave me a chance to write the first real action cues of the season, and this is where my writing for the drum kit really was able to expand a little bit. The drum kit is something that I've tended to avoid on other shows because it's a sound that we're so familiar with. And so on projects like Terminator and Battlestar Galactica, I've gone out of my way to use percussion sounds that are very foreign or unusual. The thing that I like about the drum kit for The Walking Dead is actually that it is familiar. Just like the guitars and the dobro and banjo and upright bass and electric bass and these sort of country western folk instruments that I've been using, we know what the drum kit sounds like. The way I've been using it in this show has been a little different than the way I've used percussion in my other shows. There's a lot more improvisation here, and working with the drummer Brian Taylor that I've worked with, he's just a thrill to work with because he brings so much to it. And a lot of the times I'll just map out a basic set of patterns for him, but would let him kind of improvise over it and create his own variation so that it really has that kind of country rock drum kit drummer feel. It doesn't sound like a classical percussion part. Working with Brian on these action cues has just been a blast, and you're gonna hear some really cool drum parts in the upcoming episodes. And next week there's also a new instrument that I introduce to the score, which is something I haven't used before. So check back next week and I'll show you what it is.